come from a diplomatic culture, and my hard wiring of the brain is to be nice and friendly. But here's a situation, if I am nice and friendly, he won't get the point that he screwed up. Now, I'm not saying be nasty, but I'm saying what you need to do is to say, Anil, this was not good work. You made a mistake here, and a mistake here, and a mistake here. These figures need to be correct before we send them to finance. I don't expect this kind of work. Don't do it again. Improve. Is that direct or diplomatic? Direct. Diplomatic culture will be, Anil, we're so happy to have you on the team. Everything is so good. Your work is so good. We're a happy family here. And the project was brilliant. Well, there's one or two mistakes, but not big mistakes, just small mistakes, no big issue. And if you know, some little bit of mistake, but no problem. So what does Anil do? He finishes the conversation and says, the report was good. Diplomatically, you were trying to hint when you said, some mistakes, but no problem. If you don't specify the mistakes, how does he learn and know? So global cultural intelligence. Everybody here is either an executive who works for different cultures or who works outside Sri Lanka, with people coming to Sri Lanka, you go outside. Excuse me. And so what you need to be able to do is to say, this is a tough situation. My culture is diplomatic. I need to move beyond my culture. I'm going to be a little embarrassed. It's going to be awkward, but I need to be direct. If I had a group of Americans here, or Brits or Germans, I'd be saying the opposite. And he's saying, you need to build the relationship and to be more diplomatic. Because you're so direct with your Singapore colleagues, your Sri Lankan colleagues, that they really get upset and intimidated. So you need to learn to soften your tone.